Whistleblowers are back in news with the latest allegations by a group of anonymous employees of Infosys who have raised a complaint against the management for indulging in financial irregularities. The U.S. Securities and Exchange Commission is currently probing allegations against the company, while market regulator SEBI has requested additional information on the matter. Let's take a look at how is whistleblowing defined under the law, historical incidences of whistleblower reports, and what has been the impact of such reports coming to limelight. The Whistleblowers Protection Act 2014 is an act to establish a mechanism to receive complaints relating to disclosure on any allegation of corruption or willful misuse of power by any public servant, and to inquire into such disclosures and to provide adequate safeguards against victimization of the person making such complaints. While the Companies Act defines whistleblowing as an act aimed at drawing the attention of stakeholders to instances of unethical practices in an organization, all listed and public sector firms need to have a whistleblower policy that actually outlines procedures and recourses available to complainants. Now, this is not the first instance of a whistleblower allegation at Infosys. This is at least the third time in 2 years that unidentified persons have alleged unethical practices by the leadership of Infosys. In 2013, Infosys had paid $34 million to end a U.S. investigation related to visa misuse that was brought to light by another whistleblower. While in 2017, anonymous whistleblower had alleged irregularities in Infosys' $200 million acquisition of Israeli software firm Panaya. Founder Narayana Murthy also raised questions, and this was followed by the then CEO Vishal Sikka to quit. However, both internal and external inquiries into Panaya deal later cleared Sikka of any kind of misconduct. Some other famous whistleblower cases in India were of Satyendra Dubey in 2003, who accused his employer NHA of corruption in highway construction projects in India. He was assassinated on November 27, 2003. Shanmugan Manjunath, former manager at Indian Oil Corporation Limited or IOCL, who spoke against adulteration of petrol. He was also shot dead on November 19, 2005. Vijay Pandare was a bureaucrat belonging to the irrigation department in Maharashtra. He blew the whistle on Maharashtra irrigation scam of 2012 that had led to the resignation of Maharashtra Deputy Chief Minister Ajit Pawar. Now, these past incidences suggest the need for stringent laws to protect the whistleblowers. We spoke to Sanjeev Kumar, partner Lutra & Lutra Law Firm, who feels that the whistleblower complaint has brought into light distressing unethical practices stated to have been committed by the senior-most executives of Infosys. He feels this is all the more shocking, keeping in view that its former CEO Vishal Sikka in 2017 had resigned after a tussle over corporate governance issues with the founder of the company. He also adds that this makes them ponder whether the regulatory mechanisms are strict enough to dig deep into the recesses of big organizations.
While on the other hand, the Bengaluru-headquartered firm Infosys has said that it has complied with its whistleblower policy through placing the complaint before the audit committee of its board. Now, this is a developing story, and we await the results of the investigations. And we at Money Control will keep you posted as always.